It's not his. Holly's kid. She lied, dyed his hair. She's history.
Have you forgotten what he's just put you through?
Forgotten, no. Forgiven, perhaps.
I think I'm having a breakdown.
So am I.
Did you ever think that maybe we just weren't supposed to get together?
I'm here!
Makeup on.
Oh, thanks. I'll take that as a compliment.
No, I mean, you know, you look great, but...
No!
What?
You've spoiled it!
Spoiled what?
The mirror I'd written in it.
Really?
Yes.
Right.
Well, actually, you know, it doesn't matter now, but you must know it was... I love you.
You bloody narcissist. Now get out.
Go on.
Are you going to see Ginger Nuts today?
We work with Ginger Nuts. Of course I'll see you.
Oh, no, but can't we just go to a different hospital?
What do you mean?
Well, you know, just you and me do our stuff somewhere else.
No! Go away!
Oh, let me brush your teeth.
No, get out!
I'll do the top and you do the bottom. Sue White.
Yeah? Don't mind me. Just feeling a little Morrissey today. Mm.
Like an attention-seeking dilettante wallowing in teenage angst whilst displaying a spurious nostalgia for the working classes.
Hi, that's Phil.
Yep, for you.
A restraining order? But why, Mike, why?
Because life is too short. Read it, learn it by heart, never bother me again.
Do it if I don't actually touch.
No, no, no.
What about if I spoke in Portuguese? Porque mi madre, padre español, porque mi nombre es Michel Miranda, mas me hace problema.
No, not in any language ever.
I could sniff your intoxicating trouser fragrance.
Don't do that because you sound like an inkjet printer. Go away or go to jail.
Found out about Lyndon and threw me out, told me to take what I needed and leave. And I couldn't find a suitcase. It's very hot in here.
What happened to you?
Got really drunk last night. The hen party, padlocked this to my testicles.
Sorry, didn't hurt you.
Who's there? Hmm? that you? You back from the grave to wreak your dwarfish vengeance upon me? But I won't have it, you. I won't. So, you're not real. You get out, you're not real. Are you just a midgety figment of my imagination? Be gone, you low bloody.
Hello, Alan. I can't go into my office.
I'm in my cupboard.
I can't face people.
You're in my cupboard.
Oh, Jesus, Alan, we're going to prison.
No, we're not.
Do you know what'll happen to me in prison?
What?
I'll be lady bummed. I'll end up some bitch's bitch.
I won't let them. You're my bitch.
Criminals always get caught in the end. Only watch TV.
We're not going to prison.
Well, they'll be looking for us.
Why? Why would they look for us? Where's the motive? Or why would we murder a dwarf?
Why would you kill a dwarf?
You shut up! You shut up! I've had it up to here with dwarfs. No more dwarf.
Yes, that's right. Thanks to you.
You... What?
Hungry. And I need a pee.
I'll look after you. I love you.
I love her.
Oh,
I love her.
Do you?
Yeah.
No, it's not sweet. It's cute. It's kind of cute.
It's not cute.
How it is.
It's...
Well, then just let her go. Let her go.
I want to keep her.
Right, well, suit yourself then. Taxidermist. You'll need to kill her, have her stuffed before she'll stay with you.
You know nothing about love.
Really?
You don't know a thing.
Well, go on. Why don't you tell me about it?
Why don't I?
Do you know about it?
Yeah.
Go on then. Let's hear it.
Right. Love is waking up in the middle of the night . That's about as far as I've got at the moment
. Is it? Yeah,
right,
not great, is it?
Well,
have a chocolate cup. They're quite cheering. No, not both of them.
They are actually quite cheering.
Vodka?
No, my darling, I think not. No vodka for you. Maybe a coffee or a tea.
Hi, we were just wondering whether you'd cancelled today's session because you weren't there, so we thought, well, maybe it would be in here.
Right, yes, cancelled.
Right. Is that smoke?
Yes. It's my smoking cupboard.
All right, yeah. There might be a fire.
Nope, nope.
You know what they say, no smoke without fire.
Yes, well, that, Mr. Boyce, is precisely what a fool might think. A fool who also thinks that I might keep a person in storage, and not only that, but give them a cigarette to smoke in within.
Alan.
Shut up!
What?
Shut up! No, not Mel, not you, her. No, him.
Did you say anything?
No.
No, well, shut up, nobody. Just...
Is that a glass of wee?
No, it's that's apple juice.
It's funny, because it smells like wee.
No, it's organic. That's...
Chin-chin?
Chinny chin-chin. And bottoms. Yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Refreshing.
Lovely. That's the, I've had it off. Yes. Thank you very much, cupboard lady.
Patients give me things.
Apart from venereal disease?
Yeah.
No, he's on his last legs.
The yo-yo man.
Well, I'm assuming he had a real name, but
yeah. Yeah, but you can't remember what it is.
Can you?
Well, no, but you're the moral one, so it's worse that you can't remember.
You know, yo-yo man died.
Yeah, he had a name, actually.
So I can't remember what it was.
Yeah, neither can we.
You know, the last thing he said to me was, don't die alone like me in a place like this. Find someone you love. Ask them to marry you, raise children together, and live a full and rich, happy life. I don't get it. Walk the dog. Catch the monkey. Chase the rabbit. Open the fridge. Rearrange the kitchen.
Wise words.
Yeah, good old yo-yo man.
Stroke the beaver. Smell the witch. Oh, count the ants.
All I'm saying is that you will never be a one-woman man.
That's rubbish, I am.
I am?
Yeah.
What about that new blonde girl in ENT? Nice or what?
Not interested.
Not interested?
No. No, I've changed.
Mm, great. How about Graham in dermatology?
Changed, as in I think I'm ready for commitment.
Fantastic. I'll sign your commitment papers for you today.
Commitment with a woman.
Ah.
I could see myself with about a dozen children.
That's illegal, isn't it?
Mac!
What would you do with a dozen children?
I'd teach them giggle.
I'd buy them a train set.
A train set?
I love train sets.
Yeah? Ah, you love train sets. Supposed to be for the children.
I was never allowed one, so.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with wanting a train set. That's a very good quality in a wife, woman, doctor.
If you're looking for a wife, woman, doctor.
Aren't you looking for a wife, woman, doctor?
Well, I haven't placed an advert in Wife, Woman, Doctor Weekly this week.
Which week might you put an ad in then?
Maybe he will never put an ad in.
Is that true?
Well, it depends, doesn't it? I mean, it's difficult when you're placing an ad. Sometimes you get your hopes up, and then the person who answers the ad can let you down, then suddenly you're back to where you started. I think you need to be very sure before you place the ad.
I suppose you're ready, waiting for the ad from a specific person. Do you go on waiting for that ad or do you go with another ad? You know, one that's maybe got a typo in it or something?
I think you have to know exactly what you want.
I see.
What do you mean by typo, exactly?
No, I'm not sure.
You may be thinking, well, there's no need to stare, it's not dirty, it's not a cupboard, it's a woman, but she won't come out, hence the need for this. No, sorry, magic has gone. I think I may have a splinter.
Sorry, Martin.
She said no. She said no. She said no. She said no. She said no.
Yay!
Is that more apple juice?
No, Mr. Boyce, it's coffee. No, it is coffee. Look, there. Right?
No, not that. This. No, it's about a gentleman of restricted growth.
Hmm? You mean the thing? But the pixie, the dwarf, is it?
Yeah, if you like, yeah.
Why is it funny?
Oh, well, he owned a small business, and here they've referred to him as a small businessman. Do you get it?
Yes.
Fantastic journalism.
And then what does it say?
It says, the disappearance of Alistair Taylor took an interesting twist today when it was discovered that the small businessman had run up debts of over £2.3 million.
Oh! Ah!
Yeah, his disappearance is now being treated by police as suicide.
Oh! It's ha! It made me spill my coffee. It's so funny.
You all right?
Oh, yes, you have it. You have the coffee. Yes. Oh! You can come out. Come on, out, out, out. We're in the clear. Yes!
No.
Come on, yes, yes. I mean, it's in the paper. They think he's a suicide. It's in the dwarf was a bankrupt.
Not coming out.
No, come on, you must come out. Come on. Come out.
I'm not coming out. No.
Come on, no.
I'm not staying.
Come out.
Me.
Out. Come on. Just pull it out. Right, come on. Pull it out. Come on. Right. Come on, pull yourself here. Pull yourself here. Now, listen. Listen. Everything's fine. We've done it. We are beyond the law.
No.
Yes, yes. Come on. Come on. Come on. We, this is our time. Yes, come on. Yes. Yes. Come on. Come on.
Oh. We got away with it.
Yes, my sweet.
We didn't just cross the line. Maybe there is no line. No rules.
No.
We could do anything.
Anything. Oh. Oh. No, not the pens.
Hi.
Hi.
I wanted to talk to you about earlier.
Who?
You know, as in earlier on today when you wrote I love you on the mirror. You know, when you wrote, I love you, on the mirror. Well, someone who looked and sounded just like you did. It was meant for me, wasn't it? Right. It's a shame because I realised that I didn't take the person who did it seriously at the time and I wanted to thank them.
Thank them?
Yeah. I liked it. I like that they wrote that. I like them. But, you know, as it wasn't you.
Marry me.
What?
Marry me.
Is this some sort of bet?
No. This is me, here and now, asking you to marry me. Marry me. Please don't say no. Don't say no. Say maybe, so you'll think about it, but don't say no.
Okay.
Okay, you'll think about
it? Okay, I'll think about it.
Really?
Really. Kiss me again when I think about it.
This is what you've always wanted to do, is it?
Yes.
We can do anything. Let's do something exciting.
Come on, make the call. Go on.
All right.
Hello, yeah. Can you tell Mr. Boyce he's wanted in Dr. Statham's office right away, please? Yeah, thank you. He's on his way.
Oh, good, good. This could be very funny. This could be very funny. Oh! Turn it to the slits forward so I can see when to jump out.
You are really good at that.
Oh, I practice a lot. Of course, if you say yes, I'll just practice on you. Too much.
A bit.
Yeah, sorry. He'll never do that. He never sees anything through. You'll be waiting forever. And he kisses like a newt. I'm told.
Dr. Statham, you wanted to see me?
Yes.
Is it about the reports I did last? I mean, I can do them a lot better.
No, they're fine. Very good.
Right, can I go?
Yes.
Okay, see ya.
Karen, are you going to do any work today?
Not till I know it's safe.
What's the problem?
I thought I saw a clanger.
Oh! Jesus! A what?
A clanger.
Oh. I thought you said shark. Stop it! Come in.
I am in. You're blind as well as Scottish.
What do you want?
You're fired. Go on, pack your bags and piss off.
Have you got official confirmation of this? In writing, perhaps?
Yep.
Can I see it? I love you.
Bye-bye, bitch.
Any particular reason at all?
Yeah, you're fat.
Yep, fair enough.
Hello.
No quips, no witty asides, no hilarious gags. You feeling all right? Is there something wrong?
No.
Oh, God, no. You bloody, bloody man. You had to come and show off, didn't you? Mac, I am so sorry. I don't know what came over me. It just happened. My brain got all fuzzy, but it never meant anything. It was just a kiss. Quite a long kiss, I grant you, and in fact there were two of them. But I have to assure you that I feel absolutely nothing for Guy.
He didn't tell me.
Oh.
Are you all right with the fact that we kissed?
We never kissed.
No, me and Caroline.
Fine, yeah. You all right with what she said?
Yeah, fine. It was all a bit vague, really.
I feel absolutely nothing for Guy. That was vague, was it, that bit?
Oh, that bit? Well, yeah, I mean, she was just trying to spare your feelings. You know, we all worked together. She had to be diplomatic.
Sure. Right. So if I just went for it one day, say I said, asked her to marry me or something, she would just turn me down flat, would you?
Well, I know you. You wouldn't do that.
Right. Wouldn't I?
Yeah.
Dr. Todd, hello. So, I was wondering if I could ask you something.
No, you can't!
What do you mean?
What am I in? No, sorry, carry on, fine.
Do you think that...
No, wait! Just, all right, go on.
Be careful.
Paranoia!
Cheers. Would you consider an aortal incision to be worth the risk in this case?
I don't think I would, no.
She said no! Booyah!
Although I certainly appreciate Dr. McCartney taking a moment to respect my professional opinion.
Yes, I thought it's best not to bother with your silly little meeting as you're all a bunch of bloody oiks. Also, I come to inform you that the sandwiches you're currently eating have been tampered with. They contain traces of my very own poo. So, what do you think of that, You're eating poo witches. You're playing Russian poulette. So, Yes? Ah...
These have just been delivered by Turnbull's. They arrived about 5 minutes ago. They're very good, actually. Would you care to try one?
Yes, they have. Yes, exactly. And they're the ones with the cling film on that I put there.
I think those went to the patients.
The patients, yes. And hopefully they'll all die of poo. You bloody foxies.
Joanna?
Charles.
Right, 4-6-B, complaints procedure.
Kiss me. Kiss me, I need someone to kiss me now. I went too far, didn't I? Oh!
I wanted to ask you something.
Did you?
Yeah. Yeah, well, you know, hence me standing here saying I want to ask you something.
What? Yeah, what do you want?
You.
Well, I've come to the right place, because here I am.
Yeah, no, I want you.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. Not really sure how this is going to come out, so, it's a little bit tricky, but, Caroline.
Wait, are you about to propose?
Only
it'll be my third today.
Oh, great, right. Quiet day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So, what did you say to these proposals?
Yes, no, and, maybe.
Right. So, what would I be? Yes, no, or maybe?
Oh, you're the yes.
Of course, you realise that I didn't actually propose to you just now, don't you?
No. But then, you know, you were pacing about and looking nervous. So,
yeah, that's
so
no. That's because I was building up to getting around to asking you whether or not you would swap shifts with me tonight. Short notice, I know. So you don't have to. Really, not a problem. I can ask someone else. So, it's cool. You all right?
Yeah.
Sure?
Yeah.
Good, good.
No, I just thought...
What? What did you think?
I thought you... What? You were going... No, I was just... Well, I don't know what I was. I mean, anyway, who actually wants to get married these days?
Yeah,
I mean,
man. It's just so... Absolutely. Absolutely. Of course, you could always move in with me.
What?
Well, that's what I was going to ask you before I made up the bit about swapping shifts.
Why would you do that?
Because I wanted to make really sure that I could live in the same house as both your eyebrows.
You can be very cruel sometimes.
Yes.
Afternoon doesn't really count, does it?
Well, then I should be able to see you.
Where?
No, I can't see you. No, I can't see you. I can't see you.
But look, just give me a call when you're back in the building.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, all right, bye.
Hello, no, Dr. Statham, no. Hello. Is it you? Yes. Yes, yes, I'm ready. Hmm? What? Where are they? Oh, my fuck. What? Oh, my fuck. What shall I do? Hmm? Stay here. Stay here. Just don't you wait. You stay. Wait for me.
Hi there. Hi. I am Dr. McCartney. How are you feeling? I need to borrow Dr. Todd just for a moment because it's rather urgent. Excuse me. Hi.
What now?
I need to ask your advice.
Advice about what?
About whether I should apologize verbally or physically.
Physically?
Good. You see? Unbiased and instinctive.
I accept your apology.
Good, great. I'd like you to try and get on with this as fast as you can because we're going to go away somewhere for the weekend. OK?
But what about my shift?
Sorted. I've got your cover with Dopey Daniel. OK? You're going to be fine. Just lose some weight.
than that. Good luck.
With what?
Well, with everything. Your life. Yeah, I can't stop now. I'm in a rush.
All right, well, it's good to see you, even though you are on the run, as it were.
No, I'm not on the run. I'm on the...
Game?
No, on the...
Source.
No, I'm on the...
Pill.
No, I'm on the...
Blob?
No, on the... On the...
Sunny side of the street.
No, I'm on the... On the... Holiday.
Oh, holiday. All right, well, have fun.
Yeah, I will. I better go. I've got a plane to catch. The Mexico, probably, or Puerto Ventura, or... No worry about that.
Or something?
No.
The weasel is still in its cage. The weasel is still in its cage. The weasel is out of the cage. The weasel is out of the cage. Fly, pelicans. Go, go, go. The weasel is returning to the cage. The weasel is returning to the cage. So, pelicans to the kitchen. Pelicans, go to the kitchen. Go to the kitchen! The kitchen! It's the bush! The kitchen is the bush!
Just a minute.
There!
You haven't said kitchen!
The kitchen is the...
Look, have you said kitchen?
We've arranged all of this. Look,
I've only heard bush. Stop. You're going to keep saying bush.
We worked on this, OK?
Where's the policeman? Act normal, kiss me. What?
Him for a penny.
No, me.
Wait. Why don't we just go to a motel?
Good idea. Lilo.
Come on.
Lilo.
You meant for us to all have sex together.
Good kisser.
Sex with boys.
Coming.
Yeah, of course there is, Martin. This is platform 21. And I've said no.
What? Look, there's a train coming, I promise. Look.
Look. Oh, wow.
That map.
Meet me at the station at 6:43. Wear something special. Christ, I better go.
Martin, I think it's for me.
Are you sure?
Quite sure.
God, I knew it was too good to be true. Hula hoop.
Hula hoop?
Is that good?
I think it might turn out to be a very special weekend, Martin.
Shh. Yeah, a weekend with lots of snacks, probably.
Special, Martin.
A visit to the hula hoop factory! Cool! Yes! Who is it?
From the day we arrived on the planet, and the blinking step into the sun. Not to be seen, I can't help but see. Not to tell, I can't help but die.
Get out of the car, come on, out.
Why?
Why should they? I haven't got a gun or anything.
Some say eat, or be eaten. Some say live or live.
I'm a nurse. And I've got to get to the hospital.
We're at the hospital.
Don't get clever with me, punk.
Oh, brilliant.
Right, come on, get out of the van.
It's a mobile home.
Right, get out of the mobile home. Then. And you, Mrs., with your plan. Come on, get him out.
But all are agreed. As to join the stampede.
Stay there.
You should never take more than you give.
Hey!
The circle of
on foot.
They were very upset about losing their van.
They were more upset that you kept calling it a van. I think you can slow down.
No, no. What if they jump into a taxi and say, follow that van?
They wouldn't have said van.
Yes, but they can eat dust. You see, I've got this baby between my legs now. I've got my foot on the floor and I'm going to burn some rubbers. Come on!
Shut up. Because I followed you.
How are the people of Insania without their mighty queen?
Well, they're all right. You know, I left them post-it notes with instructions. Would you like to have a look at my papoose?
As I warned you, that is probably sexual harassment. Can you excuse me? I need to pop
in here. Yeah, have a look at it later. There is a gift for you, Daddy.
Did he just growl?
Might have done. Could have done. Maybe I'd.
Okay, decaf, no sugar. Herbal, that's Harriet's. Black, no sugar. And black one's three sugars, that's mine. So who's this? It was tea, milk, no sugar.
Mm. Fucking cigarettes!
Well, it's better than smoking them.
Yes, very good. Mac, you've been in the business for a while. What would you say is the worst thing about this job?
The worst thing I would say is probably the white coats, because they make me look quite pale.
Seriously?
Seriously? Bureaucracy?
Nope.
Nope. Lack of adequate funding?
No, I'm thinking of something more specific, more patient-orientated.
Gotcha. Smelly patients.
Not exactly. Suppose you're conducting some routine tests and you stumble across something significant, something serious.
Mm-hmm.
Something like this.
Nasty. I would say that is game over. Yeah?
Yes.
It's definitely game over.
Yes. Still, you've got to face facts, haven't you? You've got to be honest.
Yes. Well, you've got to actually go and tell the patient that he's going to die, which is... I hate that. I hate it.
Quite. So, bearing that in mind... Imagine how I must be feeling right this minute.
Yes. Yeah, it's very difficult. I don't actually quite follow what you... Whose results are these, anyway? Forget I have a first name. Sometimes people always they call me Mac.
I'm so very,
Very sorry. You okay? Okay. May I?
Of course. We've explored all the options. Do you need any support? Are you okay?
Yeah, thank you.
What's in the box? That's nice.
They've been looking for this vehicle, you know.
There are thousands of vehicles like this.
Not with the same number plate being driven by a nurse with a moustache.
Well, we've gone miles. Nobody knows where we are.
Least of all you.
Come on, let's not succumb to feeble-minded panic.
Well, we're nearly there, yeah?
What the fuck are you doing here?
I stowed away. I saw you taking the van.
The mobile home.
Get rid of him. Come on, get rid of him.
I was worried about you.
You get very quiet about it.
Yeah, well, actually nodded off. Those beds are really comfy.
We can't have him in here. People will think we kidnap him.
So what do you suggest we do?
I don't know. We'll have to kill him.
Oh, typical.
Yeah, oh, that's right, because the penalty for murder is much less than a kidnapping, isn't it?
Yes, well, we've already killed one pixie.
What?
Nice work.
Look, I mean, he tricked me for saying that. Yes, he did. He said typical. He tricked me. That's a trick word.
I say get a grip.
Blow winds and crack your cheeks. Rain spout till you have drenched our steeples and drowned our cocks.
Don't give me the wheel.
I'm in charge of the thing on a
déjà vu.
Oh, we're just gonna have to sit here and wait.
For what?
Sniff rescue.
Who? Oh.
It's definitely me. I wanted to see what I could have had if I'd been a bit more ginger. It's sad, isn't it?
A bit, yeah.
Yeah. Where's Mac?
Well, he's let me down again, hasn't he? Yeah, it's just a game, bastard.
Well, no. I'm sure he has reasons. He's actually not a bastard. He's a really good bloke.
Yes.
What?
Yes to what you asked me earlier.
Really? You had a little snog and some touching with another girl when you were at school.
No, yesterday, getting married thing.
Oh.
Well, it's hardly prepubescent lesbian fumbling, is it?
No, sorry.
That's okay. Are you sure?
Yeah. I mean, I shared a bed with Marianne Selby when we were 15 and she rolled over and, no, I rolled over and touched her boob, but, she was in a pair of pyjamas, so I think it really counts.
No, I meant about the marriage thing.
Oh, well then, yes, I'm sure. There's always been something between us, I think we both know that.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Did you ever tell Mac?
No. It's very easy to lie when you know that you're trusted implicitly. So very easy and so very degrading.
No, I meant about the lesbian thing.
Oh, no.
I love you, Dr. Todd.
What? What?
Sorry. Sorry, it's just... No, I normally do the lunging, so...
Oh. Oh, sorry.
See what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah,
We, why don't we...
You go and I'll...
A is for anus, B is for bum.
Oh, is he off again?
C is for cat, and D is for dog's dicks, and E is for ejaculation, F is for suffering, G is for donut, H is for fairy dogs, I is for J.
Yeah.
Quick.
Okay. I hope they've got a buffet, I'm starving.
Thank you.